I've been searching for a ESP-based gaming console for a long time, and finally I'm ready to show you one of the most exciting projects I've ever seen. Meet Lilka. It's more than just a DIY console. It's a full ecosystem with its own operational system. It provides an API that lets you create your own games and programs using C++, Lua or Rust. Lilka supports Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, can read from SD cards, features a built-in NES emulator and 8-bit sounds engine, and many, many other features. The project was created by Anderson, a talented Ukrainian developer and his community, and today I'm going to show you everything you need to build your own copy. The heart of the console is ESP32-S3 ROM and 16R8. It comes with 16 MB of flash memory, which allows it to run NES games at 30 FPS. It also includes all essential peripherals like Wi-Fi and supports interfaces for display, SD cards and more. Of course, we need a display. And this 1.7-inch TFT screen is amazing. I never seen such quality at such affordable price. It's controlled via SPI, so it's easy to connect to other projects as well. To flash and power Lilka, you need a USB module. Since the ESP requires 3.3 volt, we also need a voltage regulator, otherwise you risk to frying the ESP. If you want to make console portable, you need a LiPo battery, ideally with a capacity of at least 1000 mAh. To charge the battery, we'll use USB charging module. Lilka supports running programs directly from SD card, so we also need an SD card module. To play music, you can either use a passive buzzer or connect a digital to analog converter and speaker. To control the console, we need some large buttons, 3 small ones and a tiny corner SMD switch. And finally, to properly connect all modules and bring Lilka to life, we need a few ceramic capacitors, resistors, a diode and transistor. You can easily find all components on AliExpress or in your local electronic stores. I leave all links in the description. I also printed a cute pink enclosure, but I didn't end up using it. I'll explain why a bit later. The only part left was the PCB. I had never ordered one before, but thanks for JLCPCB, the process was smooth and easy. After signing up, you just need to upload the required files. The system automatically sets all necessary parameters. I browsed through all available color options, but decided to stick with default green. To my surprise, I found some promo codes for new users. So the PCB production cost me just $1 for 5 pieces. Less than 2 weeks later, I received the package in branded box with the board safely packed. And honestly, I didn't expect the quality to be so good. Even now, the PCB looks like a piece of art. To assemble Lilka, all you really need is a soldering iron. And the prettiest part is soldering ESP32. First, I positioned it on the board and fixed it in place. Then, I soldered one pin to make sure it was aligned properly. Once everything was in place, I soldered the rest of pins. Next, I connected the voltage regulator and the transistor. To attach the USB module and other components, I used pin headers. Just insert them into the holes and solder from one side. And then done, flip the PCB over, remove the plastic spacer and solder the module itself. Now solder all resistors, ceramic capacitor and the diode. Then solder charging module. After that, install 3 small push buttons. Connect the SD card module. Solder the 8 big buttons. Attach DAC module. Add the power switch. For the display, I used 5 mm standoff and M2x10 screws. Secure the screen and solder it through the board using pin headers. Unfortunately, this setup leaves a noticeable gap between the screen and the enclosure. Moreover, if you leave on the bottom of the case, you're not able to access the battery charging port. Finally, I connected the passive buzzer, and Lilka is ready. Flashing the console is super simple. First, install VS Code and Platform I/O. If you are not sure how to do that, check one of my previous videos. Then clone the Lilka repository using Git or just download it as a zip file. Inside, you'll find the Keira folder. That's Lilka's core firmware. After building the firmware, plug the USB cable that supports data transfer. Unfortunately, only USB-A type works properly. Turn on the console. Now hold Select, press Reset, and then Release Select. This puts the console into boot mode, and now you can upload the firmware. Once it's done, press Reset again, and the console will boot up. Unfortunately, the firmware doesn't have English localization yet, but if this video gets a decent number of likes, I'd be happy to translate it for you. Now let's check out what's inside. Here you'll find some programs made by Anderson, including a sound generator, Tetris, and some impressive graphic demos. If you upload NAS ROM to the SD card, you can launch any classic games you like directly from menu. As I mentioned at the start of the video, Lilka supports writing your own programs. The team has created excellent documentation with examples, so you can dive into development right away. You are only limited by ESP capabilities and your own imagination. Personally, the most exciting part of the project for me is that Lilka can run Doom. Anderson developed his own port and it's available in the same repository. Just upload firmware from the Doom folder, copy the game files to SD card, and that's it. I hope you enjoyed the video and liked the project, and I truly believe if this video gets pushed by YouTube, the international Lilka community might just begin from you. Thanks for watching.